This video, I'll be showing you guys some aiming tips and tricks that will help you better in game and make you look like a pro. So, if you want that to happen, make sure to keep watching the entire video to learn all those 5 advanced tips. Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I'll be making aiming guides or aiming tips and tricks that will help you in Rogue Company, because a lot of you guys seem to like the aiming tips and tricks video that I did a few weeks ago, and today I'll be making more of them. So if you do like this, make sure to leave a like. Anyway, let's get into the video. Okay, so for our very first tip, it's not really a tip, it's more of a trick that you can do to improve your aim or like help your aim out, and that is doing quick peek. This tip is really useful because I don't think a lot of people use it, and I think this tip is really helpful for like demolition or something like that. To do the quick peek, it's pretty easy. All you have to do is peek really fast and go back into cover. By this, that game will show the enemy's health on the cover. It's pretty much like x-ray. It will show where the enemy's at for like a short amount of time, and that short amount of time is long enough for you to aim where they're gonna be and then peek again to shoot at them. That is gonna leave them unexpected, and then they can't do anything about it because it's a really fast. Just like in this video that I'm showing you right now, you peek really fast, go back into cover, aim where you think the enemy is gonna be at, or like their head, their body, and then peek again and start shooting at them. It's pretty fast, so they're gonna be unexpected on what's gonna happen. This is really helpful on demolition when people are standing still, so make sure to do use this because it's really helpful, because this trick is something else, you know, it's really something else. For a second tip, this tool goes with the first tip, and that is knowing the time to kill of your weapon. Knowing the time to kill of your weapon is pretty helpful because you can time it perfectly where they die and you go back to cover immediately so that you don't get caught in a gun in another gunfight. This is really helpful with a quick peek because you pre-fire and then start shooting them. When you know the time is right, you go back into cover so that you don't get caught up into another gunfight. To do this, it's pretty simple. All you have to do is go to shooting range and pick your main, whether it's Ronin, Scorch, whoever it is. Now pick the weapon that you usually use the most and then start shooting the AI from 10 meters to 60 meters, whatever it is. Start shooting and try to time it, all right? Like try to time when you need to stop, when you need to start shooting again, and so on and so forth. This thing is pretty useful in like Strikeout, King of the Hill, and any of those spawn game mode because it gives you that fast paced movement. This trick is pretty useful in those game modes. Now for our third, it's gonna be useful for second, and that is picking the right perk at the right time or at the right moment, whatever that. What I mean by this is that prioritizing the perk that is valuable. For example, the replenish is really an overpowered, I wouldn't say overpowered, but it's a really good perk. Once you down someone, you get your ammo back, and once you combine it with the knowing the time to kill, you can shoot, go back to cover, and expecting people to come to you, you shoot again, and so on and so forth. You don't have to worry about reloading, anything like that. You don't have to worry about that. Unless you're a Lancer main, obviously you just have to dodge roll, and then that's pretty much it. You're good to go. However, there are some rogues that do not have replenish, so it's gonna be hard. Most of the time, they do have nimble hands. It pretty much gives you faster reload speed, but it's not as good as replenish. So I would recommend you learning perks that your main rogue has so that you can think on what would be the good ones that you could use. Here's another tip or trick that not a lot of people do, and that is positioning. You see, when you're in a good position, you have the advantages. Like if you're in high ground, not a lot of people see you, but you can see a lot of people. So having good position will help you so much during gunfights, because if you get caught up in another gunfight, you just dodge roll wherever you need to go and you're good to go. No need to worry because, you know, you're in a good position. Like a few examples of this is that when you're fighting people and you're in the middle of the field, you're just in the middle of the field, you're wide open, you can't go dodge roll to anywhere else because you have nowhere to go, you know. So make sure to position yourself so that it's easier for you to get kills, so that you survive more and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, that's our fourth tip, and that is positioning. My very last tip for you guys for having good aim, or more like an aiming guide, and that is crosshair. They have crosshair options now, so it'll help you to see better and all that kind of stuff. Crosshair is not really a big game difference, so I would recommend you finding that best crosshair so that it's easier for you to predict where the enemy is gonna go. You know what I'm saying? Find your best crosshair for you. If not, you can use my crosshair. It's up to you. And that's pretty much it for our aiming tips and tricks video guide. If you do enjoy this, make sure to check out the other video that I made for aiming guide. It will be on the screen right now. I also have a video for finding your best settings. It should be on your screen right now. So anyway, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Anyway, have a good one.